We'd also like to thank our volunteers here from the 93rd CST. They're with the Hawaii National Guard. Thank you guys, all of our awesome ropes volunteers. These folks help us down here holding the ropes at the bottom. They're also helping over in the training area and also helping get all of our rappellers geared up. This is their fifth year volunteering with us. Can't thank you guys enough for giving up your weekend. We know you guys work a lot of weekends and do a lot for the state of Hawaii and all of us folks. So thank you for being here. We appreciate it. And then also FYI, yeah, we have a little bit of a nice little blessing here with a little bit of rain, but we are rain or shine today. The only time we'll stop is if the winds get pretty high, which we don't expect. Should be light breezes today.
What's that? Blessing.
Ha. Huh. And the beautiful, yeah, we've got a great blessing, beautiful rainbow right off the coast.
See him. And then see if they're part of a name. Okay. So you know what? So what happens is
so part of team job.
Yeah, exactly. So they've raised enough for. Okay, perfect.
All right, folks, we've got a bunch of folks coming over in our first about six out of our first eight rappellers coming down this morning are going to be with Team Drop 808. And this is a fantastic group of individuals who have banded together to raise money for Special Olympics Hawaii. And I believe they've raised over $20,000 as a group for Special Olympics Hawaii. Fantastic effort. And again, I think our first person, we always joke that this is the first person that's going to test the ropes today, make sure they're safe. So if you are friends or family of Jeffrey Suzuki, Jeff's going to be our first rope tester today. We believe coming down on rope B. Yep, there he is, getting ready. Tell you a little bit about Jeff. He is a sales manager with Honolulu Disposal Service. Again, everybody on Team Drop 08 is banded together to raise money. And then Team Drop 808 has been organized by Steve Sullivan, the general manager of Waterfront Plaza. And he's basically rounded up this group of great individuals who have banded together. And again, combined, they've all raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. So at least a minimum of $1,000 per person for this whole group, Team Drop 808. So Jeff, the most adventurous thing he has ever done is he's actually played golf in a thunder and lightning storm. So I guess maybe this is going to top that, hopefully. And he'd like to thank his son for being a better person than he'll ever be, and his wife for being his better half. What a nice guy. His last words or thoughts are, I should have gone on a diet sooner, and how much weight can these ropes support? Well, if you guys are worried about that, we do. Actually, anybody that's under 300 pounds can rappel, but these ropes are actually much stronger than that. He'd like to thank Special Olympics for all that we do, and we'd like to thank Jeff. And again, he's a sales manager at Honolulu Disposal Service. And we're looking forward to see him come down and be our first rappeller today. And you guys can see that Jeff has already navigated the lip. So this is what we call a free rappel. Free rappel meaning that feet are not touching the wall. So they're actually only in contact with the wall for about the first 12 feet. And that's actually a wall that's built up on top of the roof so that obviously people don't fall off the roof. And we had to build scaffolding. And so Safeway Scaffolding provides our scaffolding free of charge. They're an amazing company. And they build scaffolding for us so that folks can get up to the top of the wall. They come over the scaffolding. They got to navigate about that 12-foot lip, come down there. And then it's a free rappel all the way down. For those of you, if you've never rappelled before, basically there's a device called a descender. The rope slides through that, and you can control how fast that happens. And so if you don't do anything, you don't go anywhere. When you don't compress the descender, then you don't move. So basically you can control it, and then you guys can see that there's two ropes. One is a safety rope. Basically you're hooked into one rope. One rope is supporting your weight, and then the second rope is a safety rope just in case. If you start to go too fast, there's a safety device which will catch you and slow you down. Once again, coming down, Rope B, our first repeller today, Jeff Suzuki, part of Team Drop 808. All right, folks, for those of you looking for Denise Ching, Denise will be coming down on Rope C. She is our repeller number two. And Denise is a general manager of the Davies Pacific Center with the Scheidler Group. She is also part of Team Drop 808. Personally, she raised $1,275 as part of Team Drop 808. So, again, Denise Ching will be repeller number two on Rope C. And we've got Jeff Suzuki on Rope Rope B, and he's repeller number one. Jeff, how you doing up there? Awesome. All right, Jeff, you got to pause for a second and wave to all your friends and family and everybody, and make sure you enjoy your time up there. There you go. Jeff Suzuki, repeller number one, folks, coming down, part of Team Drop 808, who's raised over $20,000. How's it for you, Jeff? All right, folks, let's welcome our first repeller, one for one today. This is, once again, Jeffrey Suzuki. Jeff, again, sales manager at Honolulu Disposal Service and part of Team Drop 808, who has raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Thanks, Jeff. We appreciate you repelling today and helping raise funds for Special Olympics Hawaii. We hope you had a great time. Also, if you look up on Rope C, we do have Denise Ching about to come over. And again, Denise is general manager of the Davies Pacific Center with the Scheidler Group. And she also was recruited to rappel by Steve Sullivan. And this is actually her second year going over the edge. And Denise raised over $1,200. And again, is part of Team Drop 808. All right, Denise is navigating that first 12 feet, and then she'll have to navigate the lip. And once she's got that, she's got about a 300-foot free rappel down to the bottom. Again, we're 31 stories here at the Sheraton Waikiki. We'd like to thank the Sheraton Waikiki and also the Edge of Waikiki and also the folks here at Rum Fire for letting us take over this space this whole day. And we were also here yesterday for our media day. Sheraton's a great supporter of Special Olympics, and we appreciate it. Who do we have here supporting Denise Ching? All right, there we go. Well, let's all support Denise Ching when she gets down close to the bottom.
Are they? They're all rappelling? Awesome, awesome. That's fantastic. How come you're not going over this year?
I'm working registration.
Okay. You've done this before, right? Yeah, a couple times.
Before, yeah.
No, I know, but you went over before too,
no,
right?
No,
oh, you did? Okay.
I work the floor.
I thought you had gone over 1 year. Next year?
No.
Okay.
All right, folks, I'm going to keep bugging you about this today until I see everybody actually on their iPhones or Androids or whatever, and to go to 100 cars for good. It will take you 3 minutes. Right, Crystal? 3 minutes to vote? Not even 3 minutes. And vote for Special Olympics Hawaii to win a car. We have a 40% chance of winning. Only 5 nonprofits are in the running today, and 2 will win a new car. And we need a new vehicle to help us transport equipment and athletes. So it takes literally 2 minutes to go to 100 Cars for Good and cast a vote for Special Olympics Hawaii. You'll be asked to vote for one other nonprofit as well, but 2 out of 5 will win a vehicle, and we should know within the next couple of days whether we won or were one of those. We checked a little while ago, and we were in third place, but we do know that our folks are waking up a little bit later than some of these other organizations because they're all from the mainland. So we do need your support so we can get caught up and make up for that time this morning when everybody was sleeping and they were all voting. All right, folks, let's hear it. This is Denise Ching coming down right now. Again, Denise is with Team Drop 808. She raised over $1,200 for Special Olympics Hawaii. She's the general manager of the Davies Pacific Center with the Schuyler Group. We've had a fantastic relationship with the Schuyler Group. Oh, welcome down, Denise. How was that? Did you enjoy that? All right. This is actually her second year going over the edge. And again, she's with a big group of Team Drop 808 Repellers. You can look at the smile on Denise's face. Obviously, she had a good time. Fantastic. All right, folks, so Team Drop 808, again, like we said, has raised well over $20,000 as a team for Special Olympics Hawaii. They are made up of folks from the Building Owners and Managers Association, as well as Schuyler's Group and some of their vendors. And so they're an amazing organization, and we greatly, greatly appreciate their support. They've been involved with Over the Edge pretty much since the beginning, and their group, this team, has grown each year. So we want to thank them so much for their continued support. All right, folks, coming up on Rope A, we have Repeller number 3. This is Sheldon Conley. All right, we got some fans of Sheldon here. And Sheldon is actually the security manager at Bishop Square, and he likes to be known as Shell. So his office management team basically got him to do this. So he met the Over the Edge team last year and got fired up. He's actually done some skydiving, and he's been on a zip line before, but he's super excited to do a rappelling. It's the first time he's done that. He'd like to thank all the folks that donated to make this possible. He says this one is for his family, friends, and for Special Olympics. And his final comments are another good week. Thank you. This, again, Sheldon Conley, our security manager from Bishop Square. Sheldon, take a moment and enjoy it, buddy. Look around a little bit. All right, Sheldon, you got a lot of fans and fans in the house down here in the drop zone. Sheldon, you got to at least turn around and smile for all your fans. I think Sheldon just wants to come down, guys. All right, Sheldon's making great progress. Fantastic job. Again, security manager at Bishop Square, this is Sheldon Connolly. There's a smile. All right.
Sorry, John, repeat.
You got number 3 on rope A, number 4 on rope B.
You got a jump, though.
Roger that. We got it.
All right. Congratulations to Sheldon Conley. He is almost down. Looks like he's had a great time. So what happens, folks, as you start to come down, it actually is easier. It's harder when you're up at top, but for some reason it becomes much easier as you move down to the bottom. Rope starts to slide through quicker, and so then what happens is if you start moving too quick, you can get stuck. So what happens is the safety device notices when you're moving a little quicker. So, Sheldon, you got to try and pop that thing up a little bit to release it. But there's more tension as you move further down, so as you start to move too quickly, it'll catch. And it's just a safety device, and so that's what's happened with Sheldon, but he'll be good. Just so you folks know, also, worst comes to worst, if somebody does get hung up, we always have the option to lower the rope. They have enough rope up top to basically just lower them. No, we're not going to cut him down. Would be quicker, but probably not safer. And for those of you that are looking for Anissa, Anissa's coming down next, and she's going to be on rope B, and that is Anissa Kimiai. And Anissa is a property coordinator with the Scheidler Group, and she actually works for Steve Sullivan, so I don't know if she had a choice, but she is doing part of Team Drop 808 today. And that's Anissa in the green shirt coming down rope B. She'll be the next one over. In fact, she is over right now. All right, folks, congratulations. Sheldon has made it down safely. Again, he's a security manager. Sheldon, congratulations. That's a great smile right there. I think it's a smile of relief, but congratulations. Sheldon's made it down safely, and it looks like Anissa has safely navigated the lip. So now she's got her free rappel coming down about 300 feet. Again, she's property coordinator with the Scheidler Group. We'd like to thank Anissa. She's actually a volunteer for us. She's volunteered for the summer games and for some of our bocce ball tournaments. And she actually did Over the Edge last year. She'd like to thank Steve Sullivan for encouraging her. But she'd also like to thank Nick, her fiance. Is Nick here? Where's Nick? There's Nick. Nick, are you doing this next year? Maybe?
Seriously interested?
I don't know yet. That's why I don't know. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Because if there is, we could probably slide you in.
All right. So there's big news for Anissa and Nick, apparently. We've got a wedding date of December 1st. Is that correct? Are you getting nervous, Nick? No. Right on. All right. So again, Anissa is part of Team Drop 808, part of the group that has raised, again, over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. This group is connected with the building, the BOMA, Buildings, Owners, and Managers Association, as well as Scheidler Group and their various properties. So we want to thank them. They have actually been a sponsor of Special Olympics Hawaii for a number of years. Congratulations, Sheldon. Congratulations. And then for those of you that are waiting for Reed Chung, Reed's going to be coming over next on rope C. And Reed is actually in banking with Central Pacific Bank, but he's also part of Team Drop 808.
also has raised over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. And are you going over this year? No? Have you been over before? Have you been over before? No?
Maybe next year. Maybe we might reach our goal.
Okay, so we'll write your name down for next year though, right? Okay, you and Nick, right? Okay. All right, folks, again, this is Anissa coming down right now, Anissa Kimiai. Again, she's a property coordinator with the Scheidler Group. She's getting married to Nick on December 1st. Sorry, Nick, that's big news. I just have to let people know. And you guys, where are you guys registered? What's that?
Lowe's.
Sorry. Close. Lowe's, got it. Very smart, very practical. I like that. All right, so has everybody here already voted in 100 Cars for Good? Yes? Nod your head if you voted in 100 Cars for Good. All right.
We're still in third place, folks. We got a rally. We got a late start this morning. The mainland had, like, you know, a five-hour jump on us, so. All right, folks, on rope C, Reed Chung is coming down next. Reed is also part of Team Drop 808. So again, this group was organized by Steve Sullivan, who's an awesome guy, and I think Steve has done this just about every year we've had it. And I think he's going to be coming over a little bit later today. So again, Anissa is on rope B. We've got Reed on rope C. Reed was motivated to do this because he wanted to raise money for a great cause. We appreciate that. He heard about this from Julie Miyashiro. Most adventurous thing Reed has ever done is fly a plane. That's pretty cool. His last words or thoughts are, "Get me down as fast as possible." So it looks like he's making up some ground on Anissa. So. All right, folks, looks like we got someone coming over rope A. Yes, we do. And this is Julie Miyashiro coming down rope A. Julie is also with Team Drop 808. She is the property manager at the Pan Am building, also with the Scheidler Group. Julie actually raised over $2,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. That's awesome. She heard about Over the Edge from working at the Scheidler Group. She's participated in Over the Edge for 3 years. This is her third year doing it. She's also done the Polar Plunge. Julie's awesome. This is the most adventurous thing that she's ever done. She'd like to thank her beneficiaries. She'd like to thank her mom and dad, Jan and Steve Miyashiro. Are they here? Jan and Steve, you guys are awesome. Thank you. She'd like to thank them for waking up early and coming down to support her. She'd like to say hi to Cameron and Evan. Hi, Cameron. Hi, Evan. And she just wanted to say, don't try this at home. All right. So we've got all the Miyashiro family here. Again, Julie is on rope A. All right, Anissa, how are you doing? All right, so we've got Anissa on rope B. We've got Reed Chung on rope C. We've got Julie Miyashiro on rope A. Hi, Anissa, how are you doing? So congratulations, you're getting married in December 1st, and you registered at Lowe's, right? Awesome. And Nick says he's going to do this next year. All right. You guys can go together. All right, folks, this is Anissa Kimiai. She's coming down on rope B right now, and again, part of Team Drop 808. She's a property coordinator with the Scheidler Group. And again, she wants to thank Steve Sullivan. And she's a volunteer with Special Olympics. She's volunteered at our summer games, as well as at bocce ball. And she'd like to thank Steve and also to Nick, her fiance. And again, Anissa, congratulations on your engagement, and congratulations on making it safely down over the edge. Again, Anissa Kimiai with Team Drop 808.
And once again, coming down now on rope C, this is Reed Chung. Reed is also a team drop 808. And again, he's raised over $1,100 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Reed works with Central Pacific Bank. And then he actually was referred to do this event by Julie Miyashiro, who's over on rope A, coming down right now. So again, that's Reed on rope C, Julie on rope A, all part of Team Drop 808. And again, this amazing group of individuals is part of the Building Owner and Managers Association, as well as many of them work with or for the Scheidler Group. And again, as a team, they've raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii, so we can't thank them enough for their support, coordinated by Steve Sullivan. Reed, how you doing?
Good.
How was that?
Good.
Awesome. All right, folks, coming down now again, our fifth propeller of the day, Reed Chung, is now making it safely down into our drop zone. Reed, thanks so much for raising money for Special Olympics Hawaii and being involved. We greatly appreciate it. And again, Julie Miyashiro on rope A coming down next. Hi, Julie. All right, once again, Julie has actually done this event three times. This is her third time rappelling down the Sheraton Waikiki, and Julie has also done the polar plunge. If you don't know what the polar plunge is, that's the opportunity to raise money for Special Olympics by jumping into a freezing cold pool of water, where basically we fill up a huge pool with about 15 tons of ice, and people get to jump in there and basically do that to help raise money for Special Olympics Hawaii. Last year we actually did it with a huge 70-foot slide, so you could slide right into a pool of ice water. Congratulations, Anissa, how was that? Awesome, awesome. Thanks so much. All right, folks, we are expecting, I know you guys are waiting for some folks, so some of the folks that we're expecting to see soon are Steve Sullivan, Serena Sullivan, Carly Woodward Dela Cruz, Joe Pang, Rosemarie Macabante, Nicole Nako, Nate Yotoku, Michelle Harris, Jarrett Walters, Bernie Wannenberger. Those are some of the folks that we expect to see coming over soon.
I like cheesy tacos.
Once again, Julie is raised over $2,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii this year, part of Team Drop 808. She's property manager with the Pan Am building and with the Scheidler Group. And again, this is her third year doing Over the Edge. Again, she's also been a polar plunger. And this is the most adventurous thing she's done. Again, she would like to thank her mom and dad, Jan and Steve Miyashiro, who are here today.
She'd also like to thank Cameron and Evan. Are you guys, when you're old enough, do you guys want to do this? Not so sure? Okay. Who's next? All right, folks, coming up next on rope B is going to be Serena Sullivan.
So I recognize the last name. I believe this is Steve's wife, Serena. Yes. All right. How you doing, Julie? Good. Is it any less scary the third time? No. All right, again, making her way down. Coming into the drop zone right now, Julie Miyashiro on rope A. Congratulations, Julie. You did it again 3 years in a row. Thank you so much for your support of Special Olympics Hawaii. It is greatly appreciated. Again, Julie raised over $2,000 for Special Olympics, and she's with the Scheidler Group, property manager at the Pan Am building. And thanks so much to her family for coming out here and supporting her as well, family and friends. Thank you, guys. Congratulations to Julie. Again, we have polar bear babe, Serena Sullivan, coming over rope B. All right, Serena is wearing the orange shirt. And I think she's probably going to be coming down maybe side by side with her husband, Steve Sullivan, who is the fearless leader of Team Drop 808. Steve is actually the general manager for Waterfront Plaza, who's fantastic. They actually host us when we do our polar plunge at the Waterfront Plaza. So thanks so much to Steve for his support in a variety of ways. Fantastic supporter of Special Olympics Hawaii. All right, so Julie's getting unhooked. Thank you, Julie. And again, on ropes B and C, we've got Serena Sullivan and Steve Sullivan. Serena today is going by the name Polar Bear Babe. I think that might have something to do with her polar plunge, I'm not sure. And Serena is a preschool teacher at the Cole Academy in Kailua. And her motivation was her husband's enthusiasm to do something great and for Special Olympics Hawaii. So Serena has also gone up and down Half Dome at Yosemite. That's pretty cool. She thanks God for everything and also her husband. Her last thoughts are, what am I doing here? My legs are like jelly. My heart is racing, but anything for Special Olympics Hawaii. So thanks to Serena for doing that. And again, going side by side on rope C with her husband, Steve Sullivan.
He is the team captain for Team Drop 808, who has raised as a group over $20,000. Steve personally raised over $3,500 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Steve wanted to say that he loves his wife, who's rappelling with him. That's fantastic. Steve has also done skydiving before. And he is actually going to be doing the Baltimore, Portland, and Maui marathons in the next 3 weeks. That's pretty amazing. Once again, Steve and Serena Sullivan, basically our mom and pop of Team Drop 808. Steve is the team captain. Again, Team Drop 808 is made up of a lot of folks who work for the Schuyler Group and are involved with the BOMA, the Buildings Owners and Managers Association, as well as some of the vendors. So we want to thank Team Drop 808 and all the folks that are involved with them. Again, Steve and Serena Sullivan coming down on now on group on rope B and rope C. Coming up next on rope A, we have Carly Woodward De La Cruz. She'll be wearing a teal shirt. And she is a real estate asset specialist with Bank of Hawaii. Also part of Team Drop 808. She's also been a volunteer for us with bocce ball tournaments, summer games, polar plunge, and our preschool play days. So Carly's been amazing. A longtime friend of Special Olympics Hawaii. All right. Again, Steve and Serena Sullivan coming down now on ropes B and C. Again, part of group Team Drop 808, who have raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Steve and Serena, how are you guys doing? All right. Once again, folks, our team captain for Team Drop 808, Steve Sullivan, the general manager for Waterfront Plaza, has raised over $3,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii. I believe this is his fourth year rappelling, if not his fifth. He's also done the polar plunge for us. In fact, one year he's actually done it a couple of years where he's actually done our super plunger, where he's rappelled like 12 times in 12 hours. And actually one time he did that and then ran a mile after every time he plunged. We've also got Serena Sullivan, Polar Bear Babe, who's a preschool teacher at the Cole Academy. And she is also volunteering for Special Olympics, and they're rappelling together today.
And we want to thank Steve and Serena Sullivan for leading the efforts with Team Drop 808, who again have raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. And Steve is safely down. Steve, thanks for everything. You are a fantastic supporter of Special Olympics, and we greatly, greatly appreciate all that you do for us. We hope you enjoy rappelling with your wife. We noticed that you had to beat her down. That's okay. And then again, coming up next on Rope A, I think she's coming over now, Carly. Yep, Carly's made it past the lip. So we've got Carly Woodward De La Cruz in the teal shirt coming down on Rope A now. And then coming into the drop zone now, this is Serena Polar Bear Babe Sullivan. Hi, Serena, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
Awesome. And again, Serena has been involved with Special Olympics and especially helps out at the Polar Plunge. And again, is married to the awesome Steve Sullivan. What a great couple. We want to thank them so much for leading the efforts for Team Drop 808 and raising funds for Special Olympics Hawaii and supporting us every year. Fantastic group, Team Drop 808. They're one of our biggest teams and have been supporting us for a number of years. Carly is also part of Team Drop 808. And again, she's in the teal shirt coming down now in rope A. And she is with Bank of Hawaii. She's also been a Special Olympics volunteer with bocce ball, summer games, polar plunge, and with our preschool play days. She wants to thank her former employers, Parallel Capital Partners, for letting her explore a new career opportunity. Her last words are, "Nicole, wait for me." And I think actually Nicole's going after her.
Are you our leader? Fundraising happened.
Really?
Really? Who did that? Oh, really? Really? Good news! Oh, really? All right.
All right. And coming into the drop zone now, Carly Woodward De La Cruz. How are you, Carly? How was that? Good fun? Thank you for all you do for Special Olympics. Thanks for raising money for us and for volunteering your time throughout the year. We appreciate that. All right, folks, Carly was number 7. But actually, Steve and Serena were 8 and 9, I think. So I think we've got 9 down. All right, once again, big mahalo to Team Drop 808, most of whom are with the Buildings Owners and Managers Association, as well as with the Scheidler Group, who is also an awesome supporter of Special Olympics Hawaii, as both a financial sponsor as well as providing volunteers and venues for us, including Waterfront Plaza. Thanks for their continued support. Coming up next, do we know who's next yet, darling? We're waiting to hear. We believe Joe Pang should be coming up shortly, along with Rose Marie Macabante and Nicole Nako. We should be expecting to see those folks pretty soon. Once again, folks, I need to remind everybody, if you have 2 minutes, literally 2 minutes, you can help us win a car. Special Olympics Hawaii can win a car. Just go to 100 Cars for Good. That's it. 100 Cars for Good. Do it from your smartphone or from your iPad or from your PC or whatever. And just go to 100 Cars for Good. And there's 5 nonprofits that are vying for a vehicle today. And 2 will win. 2 out of 5. So your vote does make a difference. So if you can just go to 100 Cars for Good, do it from your iPhone or your Android device, and vote 100 cars for good. Vote for Special Olympics Hawaii, and we'll know in a couple days whether we have won a new vehicle,
which we'll use to transport both athletes and equipment to events and competitions. So if you can do that for us, it would be greatly appreciated. I understood last time we checked we were in third place, so we need your votes. We got a late start this morning because the other organizations are all on the mainland, so they've been voting from much earlier than we have, so we need to catch up and go past them and get to number one or two. Again, even if we come in second, we still win. So first two places win a car. All right, folks, coming over next on rope C is repeller number 11, Rose Marie Macavante.
And on rope B, Joe Pang. So Joe actually goes by Kalani. And Joe works in the maintenance department at the Davies Pacific Center. And the property manager, Denise Ching, was talking about it, and he told her he was going. And again, Joe raised right around $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Most adventurous thing he's ever done is he's jumped off the rock at La'ie Point. I've never done that, actually. Would love to do that. I'd like to thank his supportive family, mom, niece, Livia's brother, sister, in-law, Sam, Shannon, Auntie Mary, Uncle John, Lindsay, Kelly, John, Auntie Sue, Auntie Dot, Uncle Glenn, his boss, Mike, Patricia Ellis, and Carol Gomez. Kalani's last words were, did I remember to go to the bathroom? And again, he'll be going side by side. Rope C, Rose Marie Macabante, also known as Rose. She works with Securitas. This is her first time. She's never done anything as close to this. She'd like to thank all the folks that donated. And her last words are, OMG, I cannot believe I'm doing this. And she just wants to thank all of her donators and supporters. Again, Rose and Kalani going over now.
I didn't want to do it before he went.
Yeah.
I thought after he's down, maybe he'll be. But truly, I went over and tried.
Are we having fun? Tracy said that people can vote right over there.
The what? Oh, okay.
All right, folks. Also, if you don't have a smartphone or you left it in your room or something, we actually have a computer set up right now for anybody that has not voted yet for 100 Cars for Good. You can visit with Tracy, who's right down below me at the table in the black staff shirt. So if you'd like to vote right now, we do have a laptop set up where you can. It's already set up, ready to go. If you haven't voted yet, please do. You can only vote once, and it's easy to do. So please just check in with Tracy. You can vote. It takes about a minute or two, and we can win a car today. So again, we've got on rope C, Rose Macabante. On rope B, we've got Kalani Tang. All right. Once again, Kalani is with works at the Davies Pacific Center, and wants to thank Denise Ching. Also wants to thank his supportive family, mom, niece, Livia, his brother and sister-in-law, Sam and Shannon, his auntie Mary, his uncle John, Lindsay, Kelly, John, Aunt Sue, Aunt Dot, Uncle Glenn, his boss,
Patricia Ellis and Carol Gomez. I think we got everybody. Congratulations. How was that?
Awesome.
Congratulations. Again, that's Kalani. Also part of Team Drop 808, raised almost $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. And also coming up next, Rose Macabante with On Rope C, raised over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, this is Rose. She's with Securitas. Again, all part of Team Drop 808. And looks like we have somebody coming over on rope A. We'll find out who that is in just a second. We think it's Nicole Nako, but we'll find out for sure. All right, coming over on rope A. This is repeller number 14. This is Nate Giotoku, also part of Team Drop 808, Nate raised over $2,300 for Special Olympics Hawaii, and he's the Air Reps Manager at Heidi Cook. Heidi and Cook are fantastic. They have also actually donated to Special Olympics Hawaii the use of fans and cooling systems at our summer games for as long as I can remember. So we want to thank them so much. Nate has volunteered for Special Olympics in the past. He's actually done skydiving. He wants to thank the donor, all the donors and volunteers. His last words are, chee-hoo! So again, we've got Rose coming down on rope C. We've got Nate coming down on rope A. All right, Kalani, congratulations. Once again, folks, this is Over the Edge for Special Olympics Hawaii. Everybody who is rappelling today has raised a minimum of $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Some of these folks have banded together as a team to raise funds together as a team. And this is these folks all this morning have been part of Team Drop 808 who have banded together. Most of them are with the Schuyler Group and with the Building Owners and Managers Association led by Steve Sullivan. Many of them have volunteered or participated in fundraising events for Special Olympics Hawaii in the past, and we've had a great relationship with the Schuyler Group for a number of years. So I want to thank them so much for their continued support. And again, making her way down right now on rope C, this is Rose Macabante. All right, we have some friends and family here for Rose. Rose, I think this is her first time that she's done something like this. Rose, how are you doing? Was it fun, Rose? Did you conquer your fears? Congratulations. All right, coming down on rope A, we also have Nate Giotoku. And coming up next on rope B, another member of Team Drop 808, this is Jarrett Walters. Jarrett is actually Vice President of Operations at the Hawaiian Building Maintenance. And again, he signed up through Steve Sullivan. And it's actually his second time supporting Over the Edge. And he wants to thank his lovely, supportive wife and family. All right, again, folks, rope C, she's down safe. This is Rose Macabante. Thanks so much, Rose, for supporting Special Olympics Hawaii, raising over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Rose is safe. This is her first time ever rappelling or doing anything as adventurous as this. We hope you'll try it again next year, Rose. Maybe. You're down safe? You're sweating? Yes, everybody comes down sweating. All right, and we also have on rope A, about halfway down now, we've got Nate Giotoku. Again, Nate is an Air Reps manager at Heidi and Cook, and again, they've been a supporter of Special Olympics for a very long time. I want to thank them for all of their continued support. Nate has done skydiving before, so he's got a little bit of an adventurous streak in him.
You're nuts. It comes with an object.
You have to buy this one. You have to add your own.
But this one, the control has an iPhone mount, and I can see what it's actually recording.
Again, we'd like to thank our event supporters and sponsors today. Thanks so much again to the Sheraton Waikiki for their amazing hospitality, letting us use this fantastic location, probably the most beautiful location. Our folks from Over the Edge say they do this event all over the North America, and they say this is basically the most beautiful location we have for doing an Over the Edge event. We'd also like to thank Safeway Scaffolding for building the scaffolding up on top of the roof. Congratulations, Rose. Nice job.
We'd also like to thank Honolulu Freight as well as Armstrong Produce for helping us actually get all of the equipment needed for this event, ropes and all the other devices, harnesses, and everything that basically makes this event safe gets flown in from the mainland and then transported here to the hotel. So we'd like to thank them for making that happen. Again, rope A, folks. This is Nate Giotoku. How you doing, Nate? All right. Nate has volunteered for Special Olympics Hawaii in the past. Is also part of Team Drop 808. Nate raised Over $2,300 for Special Olympics Hawaii. That's fantastic. Nate, thank you so much for your support. He'd like to thank again all of everybody who's donated to his efforts to raise funds, as well as all the volunteers. And again, Nate is with Air Reps and Heidi and Cook, who again have donated to Special Olympics for quite a number of years. In fact, they get us fans and cooling systems for our summer games, which is greatly, greatly appreciated. So thanks, Nate, for all that you do. And again, coming up next on Rope B, Jarrett Walters.
And darling, just radio back when you hear him so he knows you got it. Roger.
All right, folks, again, this is Nate coming down on Rope A. Congratulations, Nate. How was it up there? Good time? Awesome. And then, folks, on coming up next on Rope C is going to be Nicole Nako. Her nickname today is Boma Girl.
Channel808.tv.
All right, folks, to get into the live stream that we have, go to channel808.tv, channel808.tv. We'd like to thank our folks here from Channel 808. They are live streaming the event. So the amazing thing about this is that we have a lot of rappellers with friends and family who've donated or want to check them out that are on the mainland or the neighbor islands or just can't make it down today, and they can actually see their friends and family rappelling today because Channel 808 is providing live streaming of all of our rappellers as they come down. So we can't thank these guys enough
from Channel 808 for making this available to us. We really appreciate that as well. All right, Nate Giotoku is down and safe in the drop zone coming on Rope A. Nate, thanks so much for all that you do for Special Olympics Hawaii and for raising over $2,000 for our program. Much, much appreciated. All right, folks, again, coming over next, Rope B, we have Jarrett Walters. Jarrett is Vice President of Operations, Hawaiian Building Maintenance. Again, Steve Sullivan is part of Team Drop 808, so again, Steve Sullivan got him involved. This is actually his second time supporting Over the Edge.
And he'd like to thank his lovely, supportive wife and family, HBM and Crestec, for sponsoring him and Special Olympics Hawaii. He says he thinks he can see his house from here, although I'm not sure where he lives. Diamond Head? Okay, maybe you can. And his final words are, go Patriots and congratulations Red Sox. So is Jarrett from Boston? Does anybody know if Jarrett's from Boston? Yes, Massachusetts somewhere? All right. And then again, also coming over the edge, Nicole Nako. Nicole is on Rope C. She's actually the executive director with Boma Hawaii. Again, BOMA stands for Building Owners and Maintenance. Building Owners and Managers Association, BOMA. And again, he's with Steve Sullivan. She's with Steve Sullivan and Team Drop 808. This is the most adventurous thing she's ever done. She wants to thank all the people that have supported her, her kids, Deja, Kiare, Leah, and Kaya. Her last words are, meet me at Rumfire. Does she have some folks that are meeting her at Rumfire? She also wants to say happy birthday to Michelle Harris. Is Michelle here? Yes, Michelle? Oh, she's up top. Okay. So we'll have to say, is today her actual birthday? Okay. So we'll make sure that we have to say happy birthday to her. Yeah. Okay. And speaking of Michelle Harris, she is coming over next on Rope A in the red shirt. And today is Michelle's 36th birthday.
Steve Sullivan is president-elect.
Okay. All right, folks, so we have three individuals coming down now. They are all still part of Team Drop 808. So Team Drop 808 took all of our repeller slots this morning. Again, they're a fantastic team. As a group, they've raised well over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii.
Kyle have these available to
you wanted me to make them.
I didn't say I wanted you to. I just
you just thought I couldn't do it.
All right, folks, so we have ropes A, B, and C, all members of Team Drop 808. Michelle Harris, whose 36th birthday is today. She's property manager at REIT Management and Research. Formerly of the Schuyler Group. She's also involved with BOMA. And she wants to thank BOMA Hawaii and Steve Sullivan. She wants everybody to pray for her. And she's open to any shots. Ladies, you hear that? She's open to any shots for her birthday. But it's only like not even 9:30 in the morning already, right? And then we also have on rope B, Jarrett Walters. Jarrett is Vice President of Operations with Hawaiian Building Maintenance, also part of Team Drop 808. And then we've got Nicole Nako, who is actually the Executive Director of BOMA Hawaii. And I understand that Steve Sullivan is going to be the director next year. Sorry, president next year. Next year. Awesome. Gotcha. Okay. Make sure I get my terminology straight. Once again, we'd like to thank our volunteers from the 93rd CST. They are all with the Hawaii National Guard. These are the guys that train to jump out of helicopters using ropes like this. Now, they say generally they only go about 100 feet, but they're also moving. How many miles per hour are you guys moving when you do it? 1,000 miles an hour when they're jumping out of helicopters and rappelling down to the ground. And you guys just go fast, right? No, nothing slow like this, as fast as you can. Yeah, so that's who our ropes experts are today in the yellow shirts, and they're also volunteering also in other areas as well. We'd also like to thank the Honolulu Fire Department, who has also provided a number of volunteers today. And then also thanks to, we've got a ton of our military volunteers that have come out to support Special Olympics, and military is fantastic. They probably provide at least 3,000 volunteers a year for the Special Olympics Hawaii program. From all branches of the military, we can't thank them enough for supporting us. Would also like to thank some of our Special Olympics athletes for coming out today. Shanti, how are you today? Shanti's out here today helping give lays and welcome all of our repellers today. And we've got a number of other Special Olympics athletes that are actually escorting our repellers to the roof. So again, we've got Team Drop 808 extremely well represented this morning, led by their fearless leader, Steve Sullivan. And so we've got, again, Michelle Harris, happy birthday, girl. On rope A, we've got Jarrett Walters on rope B, and we've got Nicole Nako on rope C. She's the executive director with BOMA Hawaii. And looks like Jarrett is coming down first. Again, he's vice president of operations with the Hawaiian Building Maintenance. And I believe Jarrett may be from the Boston area because he is a huge Patriots and Red Sox fan. So, of course, the Red Sox just won the World Series. For those of you that are fired up about that. He'd like to thank his lovely, supportive wife and family. Are you guys here today? Yes? And I'd also like to thank Hawaiian Building Maintenance and Crestec for sponsoring him and for Special Olympics. So, Jared, hope you can hear me. Hope you're having a good time up there. And then on rope C, again, we've got Nicole Nako. Nicole is the executive director with BOMA Hawaii. And again, it was Steve Sullivan that got her fired up to join Team 808. She wants to thank all the people that support her. And she wants to thank her kids, Deja, Kiari, Ila, and Kaya,
And Nicole wants everybody to meet her at Rum Fire. And again, she wants everybody to know that today is Michelle Harris's birthday. And of course, Michelle is on Rope A. But Nicole is not waiting for Michelle, obviously. But she's just waiting to come down so that she can wish her happy birthday when she gets down. All right, folks, welcome into the Drop Zone. We've got Jarrett Walters and Nicole Nocco. Congratulations, folks. You have made it safely into the Drop Zone. Again, they're part of Team Drop 808. Again, made up of folks who are involved with BOMA as well as Scheidler. And thank you guys so much for your continued support of Special Olympics Hawaii. Fantastic job. We hope you guys had a great time up there. A little sigh of relief right there for Nicole.
Now it's dry.
How was that, Nicole?
This was the cut.
Awesome, great, awesome. Jared, how was it? Good. Are you from Boston? From Mass? Spend some time there? All right. All right, folks,
so we've got our birthday girl on the rope, on rope A, celebrating her 36th birthday today. Again, folks, if you we are live streaming this event, so anybody can actually check out their rappellers coming down with channel 808.tv is a live stream of all the rappellers. So rappellers can basically let their friends and family know on the mainland, neighbor islands, or if they just can't make it down today here on Oahu, that they can actually check them out coming down as we have a live stream going all day for all of our rappellers. Again, a huge mahalo to Team Drop 808, their team captain Steve Sullivan, and all the folks that make up Team Drop 808. A lot of them are from the Scheidler Group and from BOMA Hawaii, and all their vendors that are involved with them. Thank you guys so much for a fantastic fundraising effort, raising well over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii as a team. I want to thank you guys. Again, Rope A, we've got Michelle Harris. Again, Nicole wants everybody to meet her at Rum Fire. Right, Nicole? All right, folks, once again, just a reminder, where does the money go? So all this money that's being raised for Special Olympics Hawaii, just so you guys know, it stays right here in Hawaii. It goes to help us provide year-round sports training and competition for over 3,500 Special Olympics Hawaii athletes. We do have a year-round program. Our athletes also start can be involved in the program as early as the age of 2 years old. And we actually have some Special Olympics athletes still competing into their 80s. In fact, just ran into a Auntie Vivian, one of our athletes on the Big Island, still participating in bowling this year. She's 83 this year. So we do. This is a lifetime opportunity for our Special Olympics athletes. Again, starting at a very young age and participating all the way into their 80s and everywhere in between. We do have 9 sports that we divide over 3 different seasons. We're in our fall season right now. The money that we're raising this event will go directly to support our state games called the Holiday Classic, which will be held November 23rd and 24th. Where we have 2 days of a statewide competition for bocce, basketball, and bowling. Coming up next on Rope C, we have Bernie Wannenberger. Bernie, also part of Team Drop 808. And he is an architect at Wisjani Elstner Associates. Again, folks, all by herself out there right now on Rope A, it's the birthday girl, Michelle Harris, coming down in the red shirt, turned 36 today. She wants to thank BOMA Hawaii, who got her to do this great event. She'd also like to thank Steve Hullivan. She wants everybody to pray for her. And if anybody wants to buy her a shot at Rum Fire, she's open to that. And again, coming up next on Rope C, Bernie Wannenberger. And then on Rope B, our next person is going to be Kevin Wong.
All right, so having made it over the lip on Rope C, again, Bernie Wannenberger. Bernie, again, is an architect at Wish Janney Elsner Associates. Wanted to raise money for a good cause and have fun hanging from a building. He has actually been skydiving before. He would like to thank his wife, Marla. The last words or thoughts that he had were, I could be golfing. But he's not. He's rappelling today as part of Team Drop 808. And again, coming up on Rope B, we have Kevin Wong, also known today as Kailua Ranch Boss. He works as the art director at Outrigger Enterprises Group, and he wants to do his best to assist Special Olympics Hawaii. How you doing, Michelle? Happy birthday, Michelle. Michelle, you have a lot of friends and family that are eagerly awaiting your arrival. All right, folks, once again on Rope A, Michelle Harris, her celebrating her 36th birthday today by going over the edge. She raised over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii, also as part of Team Drop 808. She'd like to thank BOMA Hawaii and Steve Sullivan. And she is the property manager at REIT Management and Research. So congratulations to Michelle Harris on her 36th birthday and for doing an awesome thing by celebrating by rappelling down 310 feet. Have you ever done something like this before, Michelle?
No.
Are you having fun? And again, also part of Team Drop 808 on Rope C, we've got Bernie Wannenberger. Also, Bernie is an architect, again, at Wish Janney Elsner Associates. And again, he'd like to thank his wife, Marla, and Steve Sullivan. Bernie says he could be golfing today, but instead he's rappelling. I think that's a good choice. Don't get a chance to do this very often. All right, Michelle, you got us to pause for a second. We got some folks taking photos. There you go. There you go.
Oh, aspiring.
All right. And coming into the drop zone, we have our birthday girl, Michelle Harris. Congratulations to Michelle. You have safely made it to the drop zone. We hope you had a great time. Again, celebrating her 36th birthday, raised over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Congratulations to Michelle Harris with Team Drop 808. And then again, also with Team Drop 808 coming down Rope C right now, Bernie Wannenberger. And then next up on Rope B is Kevin Wong, also known today as Kailua Ranch Boss. So we do have a note coming through channel 808 from Kika 643. Hey, Ranch Boss from Kailua.
I'll say it again. So that's your username or something?
Yeah, that's what he signed in.
Bernie, how you doing? Was this better than golfing? Is that a yes?
If it wasn't, I'm going to say it was a yes. All right, folks. Again, Bernie Wannenberger, part of Team Drop 808. He's an architect at Wiss Janney Elsner & Associates. I'd like to thank his wife.
Again, part of Team Drop 808, who has raised over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. And Bernie is safely down on Rope C. Congratulations. And again, halfway down on Rope B, we've got Kevin Wong. Kevin, just so you know, you've got folks watching you on the live stream with channel808.tv. You've got a message from Kika 643. Basically, what they said to you is, hey, Ranch Boss. I believe that's your nickname today is Kailua Ranch Boss. So again, we've got on Rope B, Kevin Wong, who's an art director actually with Outrigger Enterprises Group. Kevin, can you hear me? All right, how you doing up there? Make sure you take the time to stop and look around. There you go.
And actually, Kevin has done aerial photography before, which is pretty cool. His last thoughts were, oh crap. He'd like to thank all of his family and friends who've helped raise money for him. And again, Kevin raised $1,001 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Kevin Wong, today known as Kailua Ranch Boss, again with a message from Kika 643 on our Channel 808 live stream. Again, he's with Outrigger Enterprises Group. This is Kevin Wong coming down on rope B. All right, making it safely into the drop zone, we have on rope B, Kevin Wong, known today as Kailua Ranch Boss, again, with Outrigger Enterprises Group, and we'd like to thank Kevin so much. Kevin also raised over $1,000 for the Special Olympics Hawaii program. Congratulations, Kevin. We'd like to give a shout-out to his friends and family for being here and also for helping him raise over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. All right, folks, if you didn't hear me before, please take 1.5 minutes, maybe 2 minutes, go online on your smartphone or on your tablet or on your iPad or whatever you have, go to 100 Cars for Good, 100 Cars for Good. There are 5 nonprofits competing to win 2 Toyota vehicles today, 2. So 2 out of 5 win today. Special Olympics Hawaii only needs to come in first or second place out of 5 nonprofits to win a vehicle. And to get there, all we need you to do is just vote. Just vote for Special Olympics Hawaii. So please, if you get a chance, go online or just go see Tracy, who's right below me in the black staff shirt. And she has got some computer set up right now to log you right in and to just quickly vote. All right, folks, coming over next on rope A, this is Stacy Chang. Stacy raised $1,800 for Special Olympics Hawaii. She's wearing a black shirt. So Stacy actually has a number of different nicknames. She's been known in high school as Smiley. Now she's also known as Mommy or No. I guess that's what her kids call her. And on Facebook, she's Chingy Chang. She works in Wahiwa as a tantrum and meltdown negotiator, personal chauffeur, and chef to Cassandra and Cody with her husband, Calvin. Is Calvin here? Are Cassandra and Cody here? Hi, Cassie. Hi, Cody. All part of Team Chang. So her coffee mamas that said if they donated, she would do the event. And she also wanted to rappel. She found out online. This is her first event with Special Olympics Hawaii. But actually, she and her husband, Calvin, volunteered a while back. And hopefully, they'll come back and volunteer for us again. The most adventurous thing she's ever done, skydiving and motherhood. And she would like to thank her husband, Calvin, who supports her in all that she does, especially today. She would like to thank her sweetie pies, Cassandra and Cody, and all of her friends and family that came out to the Sheraton and are watching on live streaming video, especially Gary and Loretta. To all of her family and friends who donated, she sent their blessings for a safe and successful event and shared her fundraising link. And her last thoughts as she rappels off a 31-story building are, a 31-story building? I thought she said 13. Oh boy, I should have worn my Depends. And her last comments are Geronimo. Again, that's Stacy Chang, also known as Smiley, Mommy, and No. And I'm only saying it like she told me to say it on the paper.
Let's is one of the best ones we've got.
All right, folks, coming over on rope C, we have Ruth Zonuthuri. There we go. Also known as Sister Ruth. There we go. Sister Ruth Zonuthuri. And we also actually have Father Arnold Ortiz. And his nickname is Padre. That's awesome. So they're coming over on ropes B and C. Father Ortiz on rope B and Sister Ruth on rope C.
Is she rappelling in her habit?
All right, folks. Again, we've got Stacy Chang on rope A. In one of the more funny descriptions of motherhood that I've ever seen. Again, Stacy Chang's occupation is a tantrum and meltdown negotiator, personal chauffeur and chef to Cassandra and Cody and her husband Calvin. Looks like we have a lot of members of Team Chang here in our spectator area. How are you, Stacy? Are you having fun? So, Calvin, are you going to do this next year? Where's Calvin? Calvin's turn next year, maybe? All right, maybe one of the other coffee moms? Who's next? Who's next next year? All right, we'll find somebody next year. Stacy's going to get to a point who's going to go next year. All right, making it down safely into the drop zone. Again, this is our tantrum and meltdown negotiator, Stacy Chang, coming down on rope A. And then again, folks, we have coming up on ropes B and C. The Knights of Columbus actually got very involved to raise money this year. And they are going to be sending over Father Arnold Ortiz on rope B and Sister Ruth on rope C. And they're going to be coming down shortly if they're not already. Yep, there they go. They're coming right now. All right. Stacy Chang is down and safe on rope A. Congratulations, Stacy. All right. Again, she wants to give a shout out to Cassie and Cody and Calvin, her family, and all of the coffee moms and friends and family who donated to her and helped make this possible. Congratulations, Stacy. Stacy raised over $1,800 for Special Olympics Hawaii. That's awesome, Stacy. Thanks so much. Stacy, are you going to recruit some other coffee moms to do this next year?
Yes.
All right. Coffee moms and coffee daddies. All right. All right. Father Arnold, Padre, is coming down rope B, and Sister Ruth coming down rope C. Nice job, Stacy.
You want to say thanks to your friends and family? You want to say thank you?
Thank you guys so much. I heard you all the way from the top. I love you.
All right, that was Stacy Chang. She is awesome. All right, coming down on rope B, this is Father Arnold Padre Ortiz. He's a Catholic priest with St. Elizabeth Parish in Haia. He's up for any adventure he heard about over the edge from his friend Jerry Engel. The most adventurous things he's ever done, he's actually done skydiving and bungee jumping. Okay, so have you got anybody thinks... priests are boring? Absolutely not. That's not the case. Padre Ortiz is absolutely not a boring priest. He says, this has got to be posted on my Facebook page, and he encourages everyone to support Special Olympics for special people. Thank you so much, Padre. Padre is 67 years old. Fantastic. And also, Sister Ruth Zonuthuri, and she is the director of Good Samaritan Ministry at St. Elizabeth Catholic Church. And initially, the Knights of Columbus requested her, and she personally loves the cause. She says they have many missions in India taking care of the special needs population, schools, trainings, and rehabilitation centers, and she's extremely excited to also get involved with an organization like Special Olympics Hawaii. And she actually has worked for 5 days in a small mission station in Burma. She'd like to thank the Knights of Columbus and her pastor as well. So again, we'd like to thank Padre Father Arnold Ortiz on rope B and our rope C, Sister Ruth. Congratulations, they are both safely down. They both want to say thank you so much to all their friends, supporters, and to God. And we want to thank them so much. We also want to thank the Knights of Columbus. Knights of Columbus are actually one of our great supporters of Special Olympics Hawaii. So, Padre, thank you so much. Sister Ruth, thank you so much. You guys are phenomenal. All right, next up on rope A, this is one of our leading fundraisers, Mr. Buddy Botello. This is our 5th year doing Over the Edge, and Buddy has done it every year, raises money for us every year by doing Over the Edge. This year, Buddy raised $4,300. $4,300. Fantastic. His nickname is Budman. He is an artist, and actually his work is phenomenal. Does great oil work as well as pencil sketches. And he's coming down now on rope A. And again, Padre Ortiz on rope B, Sister Ruth on rope C. They're getting unhooked right now. And congratulations. We can't thank them enough for their support and all they've done for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, coming down on rope A right now, we've got the Budman, Buddy Botello. Buddy has actually been involved with Special Olympics for probably 30 years because his wife, Nancy Botello, is our CEO and president of the organization. And so he's had no choice but to be involved for a very long time. But he has gotten very involved in the fundraising efforts and has raised probably in the last 5 years close to $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. All right, folks. Do we have a lot of folks here that are here to support Padre and Sister Ruth? Yes? Awesome. Thank you guys all for coming out today. Much appreciated, and thank you guys for supporting Special Olympics Hawaii. Awesome. Padre, thank you so much. Sister Ruth, thank you so much. And again, Buddy Botello coming down on rope A right now. Buddy would like to thank Sybil, Cheryl, and Andy, Murray, and Carrie, Susie, Dennis, Winnie. This is all. Wants to thank his friends and family, and mahalo to all. And to Dadman. Last words are bombs away. Again, Buddy's raised over $4,300 for Special Olympics Hawaii this year. That's phenomenal. Next up, coming up on rope C, her name is Crystal Is Awesome Yamasaki. Her middle name is Awesome. This is actually Crystal's 4th year doing Over the Edge. I think I was the one that actually convinced her to do it the first year, so she still blames me. All right, folks, again, on rope A, Buddy Botello, the Budman, and on rope C, coming up next, Crystal Yamasaki.
Budman, how are you, buddy?
Again, this is Buddy's 5th year doing Over the Edge.
buddy comes down, can you go tell Sherry that the escort is here to bring the repellers all the way to jump?
Okay.
Not just bring them to the room, and then they would be a drop to jump.
The reason why he's taking his time is because every time he's going too fast, and this time he wants to just look at the feet the whole way down, which is making him nuts.
Why? He's safe. He's all good.
All right, folks, again, Buddy Botello, the Bud Man on Rope A, raised over $4,300 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Most adventurous thing Buddy has ever done is marry his wife, Nancy, who is also our president and CEO of Special Olympics Hawaii and has been for the past 25 years, Nance, is that right? 27 years, I should know that. All right. And again, Buddy, this is his fifth year, and combined in the last 5 years, he's probably raised close to $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii, which is amazing. Buddy, thank you for doing that. Great to see you again. Buddy's an amazing artist, amazing local artist. You can see his art available in various locations throughout the year. And then also, Rope C, we have Crystal Yamasaki coming over the edge. Again, folks, so we do have a live stream of this event going on, channel 808.tv. So we do have friends and family from the mainland or from the neighbor islands or even from Oahu if they can't get down here today that can actually check everybody out and see them coming down and actually can even send a message through channel 808. And if they do that, then actually we'll be repeating those messages on the mic so that their repellers can hear them.
Hey, buddy. Oh, that's Kyle up there right now.
All right. Also, on Rope B, we have Kyle Carioca. Kyle actually works for Special Olympics Hawaii. And but he still actually raised over $1,000. I think more than that, probably closer to $2,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Crystal and Kyle are very good friends. They're rappelling together on Rope B and Rope C. And then again, the Bud Man on Rope A, his fifth year as a rappeller. Buddy, are you going for the title of oldest rappeller this year?
I hope so.
Buddy is, can I say what your age is, bud? Buddy is 71 years old and still going extremely strong. Has been involved with Special Olympics for a long, long time. Including 1 year, he actually trained an entire year with a Special Olympics athlete, and they did a marathon together, which is amazing. And again, has raised over $4,300 for Special Olympics this year. Congratulations to Buddy Botello, the Bud Man, making it safely down for his fifth straight year into the drop zone. Thank you so much, Buddy. Much appreciated. Again, coming up down now on Ropes B and C, we have Crystal Yamasaki and Kyle Carioca. A little bit about Crystal. Crystal actually does a lot of public relations work for Special Olympics Hawaii. She was formerly with the Bennett Group, and now she has actually her own company starting up called Crystal Clear Communications. And her best client, of course, is us, Special Olympics Hawaii. So actually, I made her do this the first year. I kind of guilted her into it, but now she just wanted to help Kyle Carioca raise money so he wouldn't cry. Because Kyle is actually running this event this year, and his goal is to raise as much money as he can for Special Olympics Hawaii so we can continue to provide year-round sports training and competition for our Special Olympics athletes. So the most adventurous thing Crystal has ever done is be friends with Kyle, actually. Crystal is a coach for the Ducks, which is one of our Special Olympics teams, Quack Quack. She's also... Crystal is also the mommy to two of the naughtiest puppies you've ever met. She'd like to say hi, Naya, Caroline, and Naughty. Bert and Vera. Apparently, Ohana means coming to see Raleigh, your daughter, every single time she jumps off a building. Her last words are, "Wee!" She'd like to say, oh yeah, reminder, please vote for Special Olympics Hawaii and Toyota's 100 Cars for Good contest today. So please, yes, get out whatever device you need to. To help us vote 100 cars for good. And again, Crystal Yamasaki, amazing, amazing, awesome person, does great PR work. Also a great swim coach with the Ducks. And Kyle Carioca, our event coordinator, works for Special Olympics Hawaii, coming down on Rope B. Kyle's nickname today, Your Excellency, genius, awesome, you pick it. And he works for the best nonprofit in the universe. That means Special Olympics Hawaii. Kyle actually hates heights, hates doing this, but he does it because he knows everybody asks him over and over again, well, if you want me to do it, then you got to do it. So every year, Kyle has to do it. And again, Kyle wants everybody to do the same thing that Crystal wants you to do and what I want you to do, which is vote for 100 Cars for Good, Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, congratulations, Kyle Carioca. Kyle actually also raised over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii, as did Crystal Yamasaki on Ropesy, and you guys are safely down. Crystal's fourth year. Kyle, was this your fourth year or your third year going over the edge? Fourth year. Awesome. You guys passed me now. Congratulations, guys. Was it still, Crystal, was it still scary? Crystal, still scary? Yes. Kyle? That's torture, Crystal. All right, coming up next on Rope A, we have Fred Lee. Fred also raised over $1,200 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Fred is the chief systems officer for the Hawaii Group, the parent company of Hawaii Human Resources. But Fred actually has been a longtime supporter of Special Olympics Hawaii and actually does comes in and fixes all of our computers and does all of our IT work for Special Olympics Hawaii and has been our IT consultant since 2002. So we thank so much Fred Lee for all of his support. It raised over $1,250 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, a big shout out to Russ from channel 808.tv for doing the live streaming event today. Fred is also an excellent musician and has played with some of the biggest names in Hawaii and still is in concert quite often. You can see him around town. Fantastic. I've heard him play a number of times. And again, Fred is also a great IT guy and works for the Hawaii Group and has done our IT work for Special Olympics Hawaii since 2002. All right, folks, by this time, everybody should have already cast their vote, 100carsforgood.com. Trace, how's it going? You guys able to get online? No problem? All right. What place are we in, Trace? Still third. What's the percentages right now? Second, so we're 19%, and second place is at 23%? All right, so we've got a little ways to go to catch up. What's first place? 24, okay. That's way better than this morning, because this morning we were down at like 12%. So we've been pumping it. We've been pumping it. So folks, if you voted and you want to spread the word, if you've got a nice little network, social network on Facebook or Twitter or whatever you might use, if you want to just shoot, send a little shout out, just kind of repost or reshare our 100 Cars for Good, let your friends and family know to please vote for Special Olympics Hawaii to rent a car. It takes about a minute and a half. Again, coming down now, Rope A, we have Fred Lee. Fred is an awesome musician, also very smart guy, does IT work for the Hawaii Group. He's their chief systems officer, and also Fred has been our IT guy for Special Olympics Hawaii for the last 11 years. He'd like to say thank you for all everybody who's donated to Special Olympics Hawaii and to the cause. His last words are yippee-ki-yo-ka-ye. Yippee-ki-yo-ka-ye. Yeah, I guess that works. Yippee-ki-yo-ka-ye. Is that it, darling? Yippee-ki-yo-ka-ye. I don't know. And you'd like to say, see you at the bottom. Yippee ki yai ko yay.
Is that right?
As always, I'd like to thank the Sheraton Waikiki and the Edge of Waikiki, along with Rumfire, for their support, as well as Safeway Scaffolding. I'd like to thank all of our mission partners, the big mahalo to First Hawaiian Bank, for their support year-round, along with Clear Channel Communications and Hawaii News Now for all the opportunity to promote Special Olympics year-round through PSAs and other stories. Again, Special Olympics does provide year-round sports training and competition for over 3,500 Special Olympics Hawaii athletes. So your donations go directly to provide year-round sports training and competition for athletes here in Hawaii. All the money stays right here in Hawaii. Again, Fred Lee coming down now on rope A. And we have rope B coming up next. Keith Condon. Keith Condon. How's it, Fred? All right, coming over the edge now is Keith Condon. So if you've never done this before, basically you check in, you get your harness on, make sure all the equipment's working right. You go to the training area, which is on the other side of the hotel. You do a 1.5-story rappel just to get used to it, using the equipment. Then you get escorted by one of our athletes up to the roof, up to the 30th floor. And then you got to go walk a couple flights of stairs up to the roof. And then you got to go walk across the roof, and you walk up to the scaffolding. And then you get this amazing view of the Pacific Ocean, and you kind of take a look over and think, oh, my God, what am I doing? And then basically they strap you in, get all the harness all hooked up, hook you up to the ropes, and you step over the rail. And then they basically tell you to sit back and trust the ropes. And that's sort of the moment of truth. And from there on, you start your rappel. We've also got a great photographer up top, Ross Hamamura, who does some amazing photography. And you can imagine what the photographs are like for our individuals with all of Waikiki in the background. So again, Fred Lee coming down on rope A. Congratulations, Fred. You're almost there. Fred raised over $1,200 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, Fred works as the Chief Systems Officer for the Hawaii Group, but he's also been our IT guy for Special Olympics Hawaii since 2002. Congratulations, Fred Lee is down at the bottom. Fred's also an awesome musician, has played with a lot of our top artists. Congratulations, Fred, and thanks for going over the edge. Coming up on rope B, as part of the Kaiser High School Project Unify, we've got Keith Condon. And Keith actually works with Pacific Rim Glass Tinting and the Hawaii Fire Department. Sorry, Honolulu Fire Department. All right, folks, coming up on rope C, we have Matsushita. But people also call her Sushi, Hibachi, Sachi Nice Day, and Marsha. But her favorite is Mom. And Sachi is actually the vice principal at Kaiser High School. That's awesome. Kaiser High School is a great supporter of Special Olympics Hawaii and part of the Kaiser High School Project Unify. Project Unify is a project that basically gets regular ed students involved with special education classrooms in a variety of different projects. Congratulations, Fred. Did you have a good time?
That was great.
Fantastic. Awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much, Fred. All right, coming down rope B again, Keith Condon, rope C, Sachi Matsushita. And again, they are connected to the Kaiser High School Project Unify. All right, so Keith Condon making his way down right now. How you doing, Keith? How was it up there? Windy. All right. And again, Keith has been part of our Kaiser High School Project Unify, but he's actually with Pacific Rim Glass Tinting in HFD. Got hooked up with us through Dennis Maher. His final words and thoughts were, I wasn't ready for this, but he's made it down. Keith Condon has made it safely down into the drop zone. Congratulations, Keith. We hope you had a great time. And then again, also coming down on rope C, Sachi Matsushita. Sachi is a vice principal at Kaiser High School. And again, we've had a great project going on, partnership with Kaiser High School, with Project Unify. And she's been inspired by the Project Unify, spreading the word of tolerance and acceptance throughout our schools. And the special needs students at Kaiser bring her joy and laughter. And Sachi was a math teacher for 15 years, which was a huge adventure. And so is being a mom to Takeo, a great adventure. And she'd like to thank Dennis, Shelby, and her family for inspiring people to support and learn more about Special Olympics. So sounds like Sachi's an amazing person. And obviously has a challenging job as a vice president on a vice principal at a high school. And we appreciate all that she does all the time. All right, once again, congratulations to Keith Condon for all that he's done raising money for Special Olympics Hawaii. And Keith is down now. And then we have Sachi on rope C. And then on rope A, we have Cody Kikuda. Cody is also a vice principal at Kaiser High School. And the reason that Cody is doing this is because the students wanted him to do it. He heard about this through Kaiser High School Project Unify, but this is the most adventurous thing that that he's done. And he'd like to thank Dennis and family and his wife and kids, and his last words or thoughts are, pray for me. So we've got two vice principals on ropes A and C. We've got Cody on rope A. We've got Sachi on rope C. They're both from Kaiser High School. Again, we've got a very strong Project Unify program going on, which really basically preaches tolerance and acceptance. And so that basically our special education students are very much accepted into the school system and into the school community through the regular supporting Project Unify projects, whereby regular ed and special ed students are pairing together to work together. And it's a great program. We also do unified sports, where we have individuals with and without disabilities that play on the same teams together. And we do that in a number of different sports throughout the year. So again, Sachi Matsushita on rope C and Cody Kikuda on rope A, both vice principals at Kaiser High School. And they are both right now navigating the first 12 feet, so their feet are still on the wall. So their feet will be on the wall for about 12 feet, and then they hit the lip, and then from there on, it's a free rappel for about the next 300 feet. So I think we've got some folks here from Kaiser High School that are here to support their vice principals, yes? Also, Ducks, you guys wear many hats today. Kaiser has a big football game tonight. No, last night, right? They won last night. Yeah, beat Pearl City, right? All right, folks, so we have our three individuals now also coming down on rope B, Dennis Maher. I see Dennis's family here today. Dennis is our either number one or number two in fundraising efforts. I know he's been battling, and we believe he's raised, I think, over $8,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii this year, raised, I think, close to $10,000 last year. He's also on our board of directors and is also a coach for Special Olympics Hawaii, and also has a son in the Special Olympics Hawaii program, and also has a daughter that is running the coordinating the Project Unify program at Kaiser High School through the on the regular ed side. So an extremely involved family, the Maher family. They're also part of the Ducks. Quack, quack, right? Ducks, quack, quack. Do I hear some quack, quacks? Come on, come on. All right, there we go. So Dennis is on rope B, and then again, we have the two vice principals from Kaiser High School on ropes A and C. We've got Sachi Matsushita on rope C, Cody Kikuda on rope A. Again, both vice principals at Kaiser High School. And that's awesome involvement. Dennis is wearing his New York Giants shirt, which I love because I'm a New York Giants fan also, even though this is not the greatest year, but everybody has to remember they have won 2 Super Bowls in the last few years. So Eli's just not having the greatest year, but that's all right. Giants are going to turn it around.
All right.
Again, Dennis Maher raised over $10,000 this year, and he's actively still fundraising this year. He's either number one or number two fundraiser. We've got 2 folks that are over $8,000 raising funds for Special Olympics Hawaii. And so thanks so much for Dennis for all of his fundraising efforts and also for all of his amazing activities on the board of directors, including running an amazing concert as a fundraiser for Special Olympics. We do have a message from JLZ Long through channel 808.tv. Way to go, Cody. Off the edge you go. Chihu. So, again, that's coming through our live stream. They can see you, Cody, and that's a message directly for you. And, again, Dennis Maher making his way down. Dennis, rest for a second, buddy. Turn around and say hi to your family. They want to take your picture. They want to take your picture. Stop for a second. You got to pose for a picture. All right, Dennis Maher on rope B. Also rope A, Cody Kikuta. And on rope C, we've got Sachi Matsushita. They are both vice principals at Kaiser High School. All right, Dennis Maher making it down safely into the drop zone. Again, Dennis, one of our top 2 fundraisers for Over the Edge, raising an amazing over $8,000. And the money is still coming in, so congratulations to Dennis. Go Giants. Absolutely. Oh, you earned that one. All right, nice job. And then again, we have coming down on rope C, Sachi Matsushita, vice principal at Kaiser High School. She's been inspired by Kaiser High Project Unify. Spreading the word of tolerance and acceptance is awesome, she says, which of course it is. And we appreciate the support of the administration at Kaiser High School. The most adventurous thing she had done was she was a math teacher for 15 years and also a great adventure of being a mom to Takeo. She'd like to thank Dennis Shelby and her family for inspiring people to support and learn more about Special Olympics. Thanks so much to Sachi Matsushita, again, vice principal at Kaiser High School and a huge supporter of Project Unify. So congratulations to Sachi. She's almost down. And then also on rope A, we've got Cody Kikuta, also with Kaiser High School Project Unify. His students inspired him to do it. And again, he wants to thank his Dennis, his family, and his wife and kids. So Dennis is down, and Sachi is down, and Cody is almost down. So congratulations, these folks, all part of the Kaiser High School Project Unify team, and we want to thank them all for raising funds for the Special Olympics Hawaii program, making it safely down, and also hopefully having a great experience. Also, thanks so much to these guys for their support of Project Unify. And again, now making it into the drop zone, Cody Kikuta. Congratulations to Cody and Sachi, and we'd like to thank once again Kaiser High School and all the Project Unify folks, regular ed and special education students, along with great support from the administration. Again, a big shout out to Shelby Maher. Shelby, for doing all that you do at the Project Unify program. So Shelby, you're going to be old enough to go over next year, right? 18? You're going to do it? Nice. Your dad's going to fundraise for you next year. All right. All right. And again, congratulations to our vice principals. It's amazing. Sachi and Cody for doing this event as well. Hope you guys had a great time.
told everybody your nickname, and I pumped your new company.
Crystal's awesome?
Yes.
All right, folks, coming up on, sorry, on Rope B already. This is Scott Mackey. Scott Mackey on Rope B. And Scott raised over $1,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii. He is the vice president and chief underwriting officer at Dietrich Insurance, DTRIC. And he saw it last year, but just a couple of days before the event. And so it was too late to sign up last year, and so he signed up this year. He saw a notice at his office in the Pan Am building. But his kids were volunteers for many years in Ohio, and a close friend works for Special Olympics in Columbus, so it's his turn to step up to the plate. So he has actually bungee jumped before, but just a 10-story bungee jump, so he's pretty excited about doing this 31-story rappel. And he would like to thank all the family, friends, coworkers, and business associates who contributed, though I'm a bit worried that my cousin John contributed so much so fast. We're a little bit worried about cousin John? Okay. But I guess it's a good thing, right? So, all right. So we've got Scott Mackey coming down right now, raised over $1,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, thanks so much to Scott. On Rope B. Scott, your family and friends would like you to move a little quicker. Which football game? Okay. They want to go. They want to watch the UH game. Wait, are you cousin John? All right, Scott Mackey coming down on Rope B, raised over $1,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Again, Vice President and Chief Underwriting Officer at Dietrich Insurance. And pretty awesome. Scott saw this last year. It was too late to sign up, but basically took it upon himself to remember to sign up this year and raise over $1,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii, which is awesome. We can't thank Scott enough for being involved. Again, everybody, please vote. Please vote. 100 cars for good. 100 cars for good. It takes about a minute and a half. Right now, we're in third place. We have to get to second place in order to win a car. There's only 5 nonprofits each day, and 2 out of the 5 win a car. And we started out slow this morning because the mainland got about a 5-hour jump on us. But as folks woke up, we started to rally. We went from 5th to 4th. Now we're in 3rd place, and we got to get to 2nd. So we need some votes. Scott, just so you know, your family and friends are being extremely supportive of you down here. And they're all excited to welcome you and greet you as you make your way down to the bottom, safely into the drop zone. And they basically say, take your time and be as safe as you possibly can. And enjoy your time up there. Look around. All right, Scott Mackey making his way down right now, Vice President and Chief Underwriting Officer at Dietrich Insurance. Decided to do this on his own, basically. That's fantastic. His kids have volunteered, and a close friend works for Special Olympics in Ohio. But this first connection with Special Olympics Hawaii, and we're glad you did it. Raised over $1,600 for Special Olympics Hawaii. You got some good friends and family that are here today to cheer you on. And a big mahalo from Scott to all his family, friends, coworkers, and business associates who contributed. And Scott is making it on his way down now. Just a few more feet to go. Scott, did you have a good time up there? Awesome. All right, and Scott Mackey has made it safely down into the drop zone. Thanks so much, Scott, for your support of Special Olympics Hawaii, and congratulations on making it safely over the edge. All right, folks, we got a couple of rappellers coming over now. All right, congratulations to Scott Mackey. Sorry, as soon as I get their names, I will shout them out to you. We're just waiting on the info for our rappellers coming down now. As soon as I have their names, I will be announcing them. I'm not ignoring them. I do recognize we do have some rappellers coming over. I'm just waiting for some info.
John, can you repeat who is on rope C?
All right, folks. On rope B, we have Jane Amano. Jane Amano is a CPA with the Academy of the Pacific. All right, sorry, folks. On rope A, we have Jane Amano. Again, Jane is CPA with Academy of the Pacific. She wanted to do this because it looked like a lot of fun. She's a new volunteer. She's actually done some zip lining on the Big Island, but she is also part of Team Drop 808. She can't believe she's going to do this. Also, on rope B, coming over soon, Janice Nielsen in the black shirt.
Sorry, John, and who is on C?
I'm checking now.
All right, folks, so Janice Nielsen is coming over on rope B. All right, folks, again, coming down now, we have Jane Amano and Janice Nielsen. Janice is in the black shirt, owner of Hawaii's Hidden Hideaway Bed and Breakfast in Kailua and Lanikai. She was motivated to go over the edge to support the athletes. She actually did this last year. She is actually a pretty adventurous person. She's done skydiving. She's rappelled. She's a solo pilot. She's done scuba diving, and she lives life to the fullest. And she would like to thank the Broncos, not thank the Broncos, but say go Broncos, go Special Olympics. And That's Janice Nielsen. Awesome. In the black shirt. And then we also have Jane Amano in the white shirt. She's a CPA with Academy of the Pacific. She volunteers for Special Olympics as well. And then we also have on rope C, we have Mahea Akau. And Makea is with the Estria Foundation. She signed up because she wanted the opportunity to give back to the community. She found out about us online. She has actually done Skydive Hawaii. And she would like to thank the Ironman Foundation and Kaeo Hawaii. And she wants to say happy birthday to Ilihia Lindsay. I love you. Let's see. We also have a message from channel808.tv. From Nice Tan 60 says hello to Joseph Pang from Aunt Sue, Uncle James, Auntie Nancy, and Uncle Bob. Actually, I think that was Kalani. Was that who went a little bit earlier? I think that was a message for somebody who completed rappelling a little earlier. Again, so on rope C, we've got Mahea Akau in the black shirt. We've got Janice Nielsen on rope B, also in a black shirt. And we have in rope A, Jane Amano. All right, I apologize. Mahea Akau is still up on top. She has not come down yet, but she's up there, and she's going to be one of our next rappellers. So we're double-checking who is on rope C right now. Again, rope A, we've got Jane Amano, who is a CPA with Academy of the Pacific. She's done ziplining on the Big Island, and she's also part of Team Drop 808. She can't believe she gets to do this. We want to congratulate Jane for raising over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. And then also Janice Nielsen, who actually this is her second year going over the edge in the black shirt on rope B. She's the owner of Hawaii's Hidden Hideaway Bed and Breakfast in Kailua and Lanikai. Very adventurous person, skydiver, rappeller, solo pilot, scuba diver. Awesome. She'd like to say go Broncos and go Special Olympics. All right, folks, coming down on rope B, it says Janice Nielsen, again, owner at Hawaii's Hidden Hideaways Bed and Breakfast. Thanks so much, Janice, for raising money for Special Olympics Hawaii. Janice, again, very adventurous person. Was this still a thrill, Janice? I know you've done a lot of good stuff. Awesome. Congratulations. And this is your second year doing Over the Edge? Awesome. Thank you, Janice. Great job, Janice Nielsen, raising over $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii.
Did you find it? 32?
All right, folks, and we also have on rope C, we've got Rebecca Walters. Is that you, Rebecca? Hi, Rebecca. She's known as Becky. She works at IAEA Copy Center, and she basically hooked up with us through Jarrett Walters. She wants to thank Jarrett for his support and Steve for having an extra spot, so that means she's with Team 808 also. So, Becky, you did not get a chance to change your mind. Is that okay? Did you guys have fun up there? You sure? Okay. And then again, Jane Amano on Rope A coming down. CPA with Academy of the Pacific, also part of Team Drop 808. They've all raised part of Team 808, raising over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. Congratulations to Team Drop 808 and all they've done. Also, congratulations to Jane Amano, to Rebecca Walters. And they have all safely made it over the edge. Congratulations to all of these awesome ladies. All right, folks, again, I know you've heard me say this before, but for anybody new listening to my voice, we need you to vote to help Special Olympics Hawaii win a car. The contest is today and today only. We are one of five nonprofits. We're the only one from Hawaii in today's group of nonprofits in this contest. Go to 100 Cars for Good, please, and just vote for Special Olympics Hawaii. You'll be asked to vote for two out of five organizations, and the top two will win a brand new car. In our case, we'll win a minivan, which will help us transport athletes and equipment for events. And we could absolutely use it. We do have a van right now. It's about 10 years old. So if you guys can help us. Right now, we're in third place. Earlier in the day, we were in fifth, and we moved to fourth. Now we're in third because we're a little bit behind the mainland as far as time goes, and so we need to catch up. So please vote for 100 Cars for Good so we can catch up and get at least into second place. That's all we got to do is come into the top two. Hi, Janice.
Hi.
Would you like to say something?
Just a couple words. I want to thank everybody for tuning out here today, and I want to thank my sponsors, in particular Skydive Hawaii over in Dillingham. If you want a really big thrill, skydiving's the way to go. I also want to thank Hawaii Hidden Hideaway Bed and Breakfast for their great contribution, and all my friends and family through from Alaska to Virginia and everywhere in the United States as well as here. And my cousins in Tennessee, and also I want to thank Sherry and for coming out today and supporting me. So thanks a lot.
Awesome. Thank you, Janice. Appreciate you raising money for Special Olympics Hawaii. Thank you for your support. All right. Once again, a huge shout out to Team Drop 808. And their fearless leader, Steve Sullivan, and all the folks that got involved with that and raised well over $20,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii. I just talked to Steve and found out that he's actually also, he and his wife, Serena, both have run three marathons in the last 3 weeks as well. Pretty amazing. And then do Over the Edge today, and they're still training for the Honolulu Marathon coming up. All right, coming up next on Rope B, we've got Rachel Brunch. Rachel's actually a lifeguard in Waikiki. Awesome. And then on Rope A, we've got Leah Okudara. Do we have some fans of Leah? Is it Leah or Leah? Leah, okay. Leah Okudara. All right. So Leah actually works in public relations for Stryker Weiner and Yokota Public Relations, and she also for Lululemon Athletica. She wanted to raise money and rappel for a good cause. She actually saw us through the newspaper. She's actually done skydiving before but wants to try rappelling. And so she's going to do a 31-story rappel to a mimosa brunch. You guys are going to go have brunch after this? There you go. All right, that's Leah Okudara. And then also on Rope C, we've got Mahea Akau. Mahea Akau. So we've got Rachel Brunch on Rope B. We've got Leah Okudara, Rope A, and Mahea Akau with the Estria Foundation on Rope C.
We're still in third place.
Still early.
It's
about 10:30 in the morning.
I know.
We were in, when I woke up this morning, we were fourth by a long shot. I voted this morning, we're like 12% hour 19%.
Okay.
So
I didn't know if you're out of country, they won't let you vote. I have a lot of people.
of country.
Yeah, if you're like my friends in France, they won't buy those groceries.
This is Toyota USA, maybe.
All right, folks, again, Rope B, we have Rachel Brunch. Rachel is a lifeguard here in Waikiki, saving folks every day. And she'd like to thank Mahea and Che. Then we've got Leah Okudara on Rope A. She does public relations with Stryker Weiner and Yokota PR. And then we've got on Rope C, Mahea Akau, and she's with the Estria Foundation. She wanted the opportunity to give back to the community. And she'd like to thank the Ironman Foundation and Kaeo Hawaii. And she wants to say happy birthday, Ilihia, Lindsay, I love you. Again, guys, vote, please, today. Vote for 100 Cars for Good. We're still in third place. We need to get to second place. Second place. So right now should be our peak time for our Hawaii voters to start getting in there and voting. So if you haven't had a chance yet, please vote. 100 Cars for Good. Take you about a minute and a half. And the more votes we get, the better chances we have to get into the top two and can win a car from Toyota. Again, we made it into the finals already. We had to submit a grant application just to make it into the top 250 nonprofits, and they're giving away 100 cars to 100 of those 250. So 40% will win, and we really want to be there. So please vote 100 Cars for Good. Vote for Special Olympics Hawaii. And if you're active on social media, if you guys can please post and repost and share 100 Cars for Good. Get your friends and family to vote for us. If you're willing to send an email, that'd be great. All right, folks, again, coming over now, Rope A, Leah Okudara. Rope B, Rachel Brunch. Rope C, Mahea Akau. Guys, you got to give it up for Mahea, too. Come on. All right, there we go. All right. Leah's in the maroon shirt. Rachel is in the black and blue stripes. And Mahea is in a black shirt.
Friends? Do we know? We don't know.
Why are they coming down together?
Looks like it. Yeah.
All right, folks, and if you're wondering what this is all about, again, this is a fundraiser for Special Olympics Hawaii, where everybody who rappels today has raised a minimum of $1,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii to get the opportunity to rappel off the side of the Sheraton Waikiki. And in talking to a lot of folks who've had experience rappelling, apparently there's not very many rappels where you get to go more than 100, 150 feet. So this is a pretty big thrill for a lot of folks. I had the opportunity to do this the first couple of years, and it's pretty amazing. Even after doing it a couple times, your heart still kind of beats right out of your chest when you kind of look over and you sit into the harness. So it's kind of an amazing experience. We actually were lucky enough to sell out this year. We actually were able to get every slot filled. We had some amazing teams that got involved, including Team Drop 808, also the Winter Zone and the Kaiser Project Unify teams. Brought in a lot of folks that are rappelling today. And then a lot of individuals who just heard about it through either social media or in the paper, or their friends and family are involved with Special Olympics, or they're volunteers and they decided to give it a shot. We actually do get a lot of individuals that want to conquer their fear of heights and figure this is as good a chance as any to do it. And so take a shot and rappel over the edge. It's very safe though, but it is absolutely scary as heck. And so Rope A, again, Leah Okudara, is with public relations with Stryker Weiner and Yokota PR, along with Lululemon Athletica. And she's done skydiving before, but obviously this is a great experience, great opportunity for her. She wants to thank her family and friends for their support and their donations. And she's looking forward to her mimosa brunch after this. So maybe she's got somebody that's going to be treating her today. I don't know. All right. And then on Rope B, we've got Rachel Brunch. Rachel works right here in Waikiki as a lifeguard. And she wants to thank Mahea and Che. And then we actually have Mahea on Rope C. So obviously Rachel and Mahea are friends. And Mahea works at the Estria Foundation. And she wanted an opportunity to give back to her community. She found out about Over the Edge online. She hasn't been involved in Special Olympics Hawaii before, but wants to get more involved. And she has also done skydiving with Skydive Hawaii. And Mahea would like to thank the Ironman Foundation and Kaeo Hawaii. And Mahea, again, wants to wish a happy birthday to Ilihia Lindsay. Wants to tell her that she loves you. And again, the reason we're raising money is for Special Olympics Hawaii. We provide year-round sports training and competition for over 3,500 Special Olympics Hawaii athletes. We provide opportunities in 9 different sports. We do track and field, swimming, powerlifting, softball, golf, soccer, bocce, bowling, basketball, and I think that's it. And we run about 40 competitions a year, and our coaches go through a comprehensive training program in order to coach our athletes. Again, a big mahalo to the Sheraton Waikiki for their continued support of this event. Also, thanks to Channel808.tv for live streaming this event today. Thanks to Safeway Scaffolding for providing the scaffolding up on top of the roof.
Thank you.
Also, thanks to the 93rd CST. They're with the Hawaii National Guard. They are our ropes volunteers today. They're also they're here down in the drop zone, but also over in the training area. And they're also helping us with all the gear and getting everybody geared up and keeping everybody safe today. All right, and our ladies are making the way down into the drop zone again. Rope A, Leah Okudara. Rope B, Rachel Brunch, lifeguard right here on Waikiki. And on Rope C, Mahea Akau. Congratulations to these ladies. How was it, ladies? All good? Awesome. All right, that's one of the best poses we've seen all day. That's Leia on rope A. All right, congratulations to Leia Okudara, and Mahea Akau is down safely. Congratulations, Mahea. And coming down on rope B, we have Rachel Brunch. Rachel's our lifeguard right here in Waikiki. So got to see the water from a whole different perspective today. Again, thanks so much to these ladies for supporting Special Olympics Hawaii. Like I mentioned, everybody has raised over $1,000 to participate in Over the Edge. Leah actually raised over $2,000 this year for Over the Edge. All right, congratulations, Mahea. Great job. Awesome. And again, congratulations to Leah and Rachel as well. Fantastic job. Did you guys have fun? How was that, Mahea? All good? Congratulations. Awesome. Rachel, how was it seeing Waikiki from that angle? Interesting. Thank you. All right, coming up next on Rope B, we have Kiana Paez. Kiana is a game attendant at Winter Zone at Ward. Winter Zone is actually one of our awesome teams. I believe Winter Zone has raised over $30,000 for Special Olympics Hawaii Over the Edge. And Kiana is one of our youngest. You have to be 18 to go over the edge, and Kiana is 18.